And this is the reason when an individual attains immaturity on all the three levels, he attains to a state which is beyond body, mind and intellect. Now coming back, so what did Krishna say? That the sex energy has to move from there and reach to the other center. You are no more inflicted by it. Instead, you have subdued it. You understand the physical needs of the other. You understand the emotional needs of the other and the spiritual needs of the other. Then the sex energy does not remain at the center where it is. Now satiation reaches its fruition and out of that renunciation comes. It is like when you have eaten food, you are hungry. And when you have eaten a balanced meal, you remain satiated for a certain period of time. But when sex is fulfilled at all the levels, a kind of a satiation comes, which is known as renunciation. Then you remain as friends, as partners, two bodies and one being, one soul, completely merged into one another. And there may not be the need of the physical as well. But if it does, it has no problem with it. But the renunciation happens. So in Hinduism, there are five kanya. Kanya means girls. They are known as virgin. Ahilya is one of them as worship. Although she had the physical needs and for that she has to go into relation with another person, but her cause her commitment to the cause of her husband, his ways and means was total. It was not in any way severed. She is known as worshipped as one of the virgin. The next is Kunti, who had the children born out of five relations. She is considered as Draupadi. She had five husbands. It was a mystical reason. She said when she enters into relation with one of the brothers, after 1 year, she will go into penances to remove the memory of that relation. Only then she will enter into relation with the other brother. We get into problems, we abandon that relation, but the memories of that relationship remain and we enter into another relationship. Another state of failure. One who has entered into another physical relation has not attained fulfillment from the second. It would have been very rare if it does happen. I had mentioned to many of the seekers who had asked me the question on this aspect to go into your past relation. There would have been some moments of total fulfillment. Try to relive those moments. Try to forgive your spouse for all the things that you think he or she should have not done. That forgiveness, one of the greatest quality. It comes only when there is understanding at the spiritual lane, not otherwise. So all these things when put together, this is when you are going into your past relations. And also remember that when you for the first time met your spouse, you did not listen to anyone. People told you that you should not enter into that relation because that man or the woman is not the right person for you, but you did not listen. This is known as the first day when you met and how love blossomed into you. If you remember that, the first day, the episode of the first day when both of you met and how love blossomed into you, if you remember that again and again, the anniversary should be a remembrance of that meeting at the first day, the first meeting. There is a beautiful incident in the life of King Akbar. There was a poor man and it happened that he was very honest and the king felt that this man was very honest. He inducted him into his army and slowly and slowly he was promoted to the post of the chief of the army. And he was a very honest and loyal person. But every day he used to lock himself into a room in the evening and will remain there for some time. Around the king's people are always jealous. They cannot see the prosperity or the progress of the other. So they went and told the king that every day this man locks up himself into the room, and I don't know what he does, whether he conspires against you or anything else. Kings are the most afraid people. So he decided to test himself. He made a peephole in the room, and at the appointed time, the man went into the room, he locked himself, and king was watching what the man is doing. He was all alone in the room. He went to a cupboard, took out an old rag bag, and undressed himself, put on the clothes that were in that bag, and stood up in front of the mirror, and he went into a state of prayer, and then he changed his clothes, put the old rags back into the bag and into the cupboard. The king plundered into the room and asked him, what is the reason? He said, sir, when I came to you, I was a very poor person. I did not have the means of livelihood. I did not have the clothes. And these clothes that are there in that bag are symbolic of my state when I met you for the first time. So every day I must remember, that is my prayer, that how I came to you in rags and you showed your compassion on me and inducted me into the army, and because of your grace I have been now promoted to the position of the chief of the army staff. So I do not want to forget my first day in your company. In Sufism, this is called the remembrance of the Roza Awwal. Roza means day. Awwal means first. First day when you came into the master. If one remembers that, there is no possibility of it falls. So on a day of your anniversary, you must remember going to the first day, how love blossomed into you, how the seeds of love were sown and began to blossom into you. Remembrance of that will save you from any kind of problems. Renewing that, speaking to one another about that, is one of the most sacred aspects of the male-female relation. Now, the fulfillment of the physical plane, emotional plane, and the spiritual plane, then you develop an aura around you, which is the very essence of a sheikh or a master. When he says something, this particular center, which is the center of the third eye, is known as the, through that center, when you look into anything, that immediately destroys all negativities. It is said, when Shiva was sitting in meditation and the god of love tried to dissuade him from his meditation so that he cannot enter into that state, he came and with all his retinue and tried to subdue him, he opened his third eye, and with that the god of love was burned into ashes. So that kind of power comes into the master with the third eye when it is awakened, that any negativities, whether it is jealousy or anything, he just looks into with that penetrating vision that disappears. This is an awareness. This is a center of total awareness. With that awareness, whenever he looks at anything or instructs the seeker, it brings about a transformation. It is from that level the master instructs. When you narrate your problem to him, he carries his energy to there, reaches to that center and gives you an instruction which you are bound to follow. So all these things put together, then when you understand this, you are able to give the fulfillment at the physical, emotional and spiritual plane to your spouse. The energy reaches to that. There is no need to have a jealousy. There is no need to have anything other than that. The Hindu scripture is full of all those incidents where a particular sage has two wives and they live like sisters. There is no jealousy among them because there is a deeper reason for it. Sage Kashyap has two wives, and out of that two set of children were born. These are not mere stories. Instead, these are symbols to decode deeper aspects of life. In Krishna's life, his father Vasudeva was married to a woman named Rohini. Then he enters into relation marriage with Krishna's mother, that is known as Devaki. And there was a forecast that the eighth child of Vasudeva and Devaki will be the destroyer of the king Kans, who was the brother of Devaki. So he put them into prison, and one by one he destroyed each of the offsprings. When the seventh child was to be born, through yog maya, through the psychic powers, that the womb was transferred from Devaki to Vasudev's first wife Rohini, and that happens. Master, when someone comes that I do not have a child, or something happens, through that master instructs and something happens. Just a thought that comes to the master is not that he does. He knows that everything happens because of certain cosmic forces, but he is able to harness, bring those forces together, and he is aware that this is what is happening. It is not his doing. He is simply aware of that it is happening. With this, although this topic is not finished, I will pause.